Professor Lai's kind words, introduction. And also I will congratulate the compliance committee, especially the Professor Lai and Professor Kong, the invitation for me to give a talk here. It is my best pleasure and honor to give a talk here. And I graduated from this university in 1982. So it's 35 years ago. I'm so happy to come back to this campus. Even the many building and the many campus is the changed a lot. I'm so happy to come back. And also, I'm very happy to meet many old friends, good friends in here, like Professor Kingsley Hans, the senior professor Ota San, many friends in here, like Professor Hans and Professor Brand, attend the conference 20 years ago in university. Especially the Professor Marcus Berlin. And I have a few joint work with him, and I learned and benefit much from him. He introduction for him, he supervised 36 PhD students. I'm not the 36, I'm another plus. 36 plus one half. So he's my second supervisor after when I first start and when I'm meeting the security. So I learned much knowledge from him. So today it is my great pleasure to give talk to him. So the talk today is not for specific paper. It covers a few of my previous research and the current research in progress and other scholar is document a comprehensive trend in the international trade. So now globalization, everything. The globalization have great unbounded. You know, because globalization, we don't need to locate production and market data. Because the trade costs, transportation costs increasing much. Also, we don't need to locate all the production stage in the same location because the communication and the coordination costs also is increased. So now we have many the production arrangement, offshore vertical specialization, vertical integration, and global chain value chain. And also we find in the many people data. Now trade intermediate goods account about 2/3 of the total international trade. So that means what? In maybe a year before the 2000, many the models, the model is based on the final good trade. But now 2/3 of the trade is account by intermediate good. So maybe the result will be changed. So now everything is looks like change a lot. So for example, we can look at most of the trade model before the 2000 is just talking about this part. Now, the company or firm don't need to produce everything for themselves. Sometimes they were outsourcing this in the vehicle to the other firm in the domestic, in the same country. Sometimes the firm will outsourcing the component or intermediate good to the other country. And so they will be outsourcing, not produce anything for themselves. Also, sometimes they will foreign direct investment in the other country. So now the structure of international trade is changing now. So now, what's the impact? What's the result? This is how much the welfare gain of the trade. For example, the president of US, Donald Trump, he always claimed the globalization, the international trade is a loss for US. So they try to protect for US. Then, but now he's thinking about another. So maybe he's thinking loss and the gain must be more serious considered, which is loss, which is a gain. Also, impact on employment. I think many labor economists also were interested on this topic because the globalization, the international trade, many firms will move up to the production cost, the low production cost. Like Taiwan, many firms move from Taiwan to mainland China 20 years ago. But now also move from the mainland China to the Southeast Asia. So the firm is moved everywhere to this globalization. Also, the trade imbalance also is key issue. And another two key issues also now is also very interesting in the economies like income inequality. Income inequality between the country and the income inequality within the country. Then also many trade scholars try to how to solve this trade bill. And also many scholars in yesterday and today work with the impact on development. Another issue. Of course, some scholars use the quantitative model to integrate, but for economists, that this is not enough because we need to solid the analytical result. So now the trade model are more diversely based on the micro foundation. Now we not only rely on the aggregate data. Like 20 years ago, many trades depend on aggregate data. They don't country or based on the country. But now many the micro data are available. 2-4 digits firm data, 6 digits of data. Now it's more available. So now many international trade articles more based on the micro data and developing the micro foundation theory. Also in the economic methodology, now also development will match. And there will be very many good economic methods will have some drawback of the method before. So now many the economic model now is used in the trade model. Also in the data source, now also many international input output table are available. When I studied UN 30 years ago, I took the input output model from we only based on the input output data by US state, but we haven't looked the input output table from the international country. But now it's many. I will give the some example later. So I want to give my talk follow this way. This is what the new development of the trade model. I want to from the demand side, preference side, production side, and also what's the implication for the welfare gain from trade. And in the economic model, I want to introduce now is a more popular use in the international trade equation yesterday, and also we put a faster estimation issue on the trade. And in global value chain, we were mentioning about the production investment and the offshore trade very evident. And also, I want to introduce some available data on the this view. So the workforce trade model for many micro foundation, I think if you are familiar from NGAP model, in this field, from the Amigan 1969 paper up to the Bokuman paper for NEG model from 1980 to 2000, and the Bokuman and the number the QJ paper, including the intermediate good input or the input output model. Also, intercoupling, including the Ricardian model in the G trade. Also, Max model in 2003 considered the heterogeneous of the firm productivity. All this model is very, very unique and based on the constant elasticity of the substitution utility function. So, no matter what they are diverse, but they always be based on the CS utility function. Then, you can consider the one factor, one sector economies, the end manufacturer sector employing the labor to produce a continual differential or horizontal differential good, and each agent consume all the goods over the variety. So we have the elasticity of substitution sigma between variety. We also have the parameter interpret the consumer not for the variety. So now we have a problem. Actually, this problem I find 10 years ago. This is but I can fix it. But recently, many scholars to fix this problem. This is you can see the sigma, the parameter sigma, interpret the substitute between the variety in the production side. The also denote the love of the variety for the consumer. So this looks very strange for the same parameter, but they interpret from production side and consumer side. For example, the mass of the potassium variety around the world is the N. Then the available variety is the N, maybe small and less than equal than N. So the CS utility function like this one. And the S omega is represent the consumer, the quantity of consumer variety. And all possible the variety must be consumed for the consumer. So no cheap price. So in this model, any consumer must be consumed all the variety provided the world, no matter produced in domestic country or foreign country. So this kind of utility function is a homocentric preference. Then we find some problem for this kind of the utility function. The first is the constant markup, the substitution between variety and the love for variety is a constant signal. And the markup also is a constant. Then, if there is a 100 variety in the market, or 1,000 or 10,000 variety in the market, the markup always constant. This is difficult to understand why. So this kind of model is fail to capture the pro-competitive effect. You know, if the variety in the world is 1,000 and the other is 10,000, it supposed must be very different. for the markup for the different substitution. So in last few years, maybe from last 5 years, some scholars are many too thinking about this key issue. So they've developed like variable electricity of substitution. That means the sigma is not only depends, it's not constant. Well, it depends on S is the quantity of heat consumed for each variety and the number of variety heat consumed. And the markup is not constant. It will be emergent determined. Determine how many variety you consume and how many variety in the market. So this is not constant. Also, that can capture the property effect. That means if the trade cost is very high, I don't consume the foreign product, I just consume the domestic product. But in CS, where you consume the whole the variety in the world. So that will be, from then, develop some new approach for the VS. The first is, this is a general form, is additive the separated utility function. So I think the T's and his few research partner in Russia development published this paper in this camp. And also published in CAT this year. And the Chimu Chen and the Zhao Zi also use this model to talking about the other whole market effect based on this model. So this model now is continued to develop. So this kind of model is based on this model, the consumer don't necessarily to consume all possible variety on the rule. So they have the chart price effect. That means if the import price is very high, then we don't need to consume the foreign product. So the sigma is not constant, right? It depends on this one. And after that, they have some specific form for additive separable utility function. For example, this is a constant observed viscous aversion function. This they specify the utility function as they specify the utility function like this one. Okay. So here the beta is index of the consumer love variety and the sigma the markup or substitution is not only depends on beta, also depends on X. So it must be endogenous determined. Also have another strong barrier preference. This utility function is developed in the 1950s, but nobody used in the international trade. But now, for now, we source this model and try to use these kinds of the model in trade. So some in the 2014 and 2015. Use this model. So also the consumer don't need to consume all the variety and they have the chart price. The other is also is HARA. This is a high-quality obsolete risk averaging the utility function. This utility function is specified like this one. So it looks very complicated. The utility function will depend on alpha, beta, and the gamma, the three key parameters. Also, this is very general form, and they will converge to a few popular utility functions that we can mention. The consumer don't need to necessarily to consume all possible variety. He only consume a subset of the variety, and the sigma also depends on alpha, beta, and the gamma. What's the alpha beta gamma? I will introduce. But this HARA preference in D function is very general. So if the alpha equals 0 and the gamma converges to 1, then this UT function will reduce to linear UT function. And if alpha equals 0 and the gamma is between 0 and 1, this UT function will be reduced to a CS UT function or constant relative risk aversion to UT function. And if alpha equals 1, the gamma approaches to negative infinity, then this UT function will be reduced to color UT function. And if gamma equal to the gamma approach to 0, then this UT function will be converged to strong theoretical UT function. So this color UT function is very general. And now I and some of my research partner try to use this general UT function to study some trade number, but now it's still in progress. It's complicated. So what's the alpha? Unlike CS, only one parameter here. We have three different parameters. So three different parameters denotes two different economic conditions. Alpha is the consumer intronicity endowment of each variety. And the gamma is inverse index of the product differentiation. And the beta is the, it represents the consumer love for variety. So here, the parameter in preference side and the parameter in the production side is different. One is beta, one is gamma. But in CS, they use the same parameter to denote the demand side and the production side. This is unrealistic. So the other is also very famous use in the NG model. We call the OTT. The other two TT is also my course, Takuchi and Japanese. They use this model. This model is a quasi-linear model. And alpha is intensive preference for differential good, and beta is the measure the consumer love for variety. And also in this kinds of model, it's different with the CS. Consumer don't need to consume all the variety. So it also has check price infinite. So this UT function also is neither homothetic nor adding. So we have like this tree. The VES, the variable elasticity substitution UT function, cover the quadratic, additive, the separate preference, and the additive separate different UT function also cover the power can reduce to the color CS stop period. So now, many scholars, Japan, Europe, US, continue move from the CS to the VES. But all the analytical is well covered. So because this UT function is more complicated compared to CS. Then why we will use the VES? Because some conventional result under the CS is not robust. For example, the markup. Some scholars actually in the IER 2014, they use the firm level data, and they're talking about the trade cost decrease. Then the markup is not constant, it's ambiguous. Also, Chen and Chen is working data. They also talking about this markup. The markup it also is not constant. Also, it's not a monotony. Some terms will be increasing and will be decreased. So the CS function induce the cancer knockout will be faced much challenge on use the data. We can face some challenge. The other is a home market. I think in AT model, under the CS utility function, the home market effect, it might not be home market effect. The bit size, the market have high weight, but they have faced the same charge use the data. So, home market effect, but always hope if we consider use to ES the production function. So I summarized these two kinds of different model. One is a very famous study, maybe I think more than 80% of the Choi or NT model is based on CES. They have the conversative preference and no chip price effect. And electricity sales substitution between the variety always constant, markup always constant. Home market effect always positive. But ODD is no homocentric preference and have chip price. Electricity is variable, markup is variable, and also have market, and the markup, home market effect is positive. The other now is we summarize in here. The most important is that the markup is not constant anymore. So well, it depends on the variety you consume or the variety supply in the market. Also, we find some another very different key function. For example, like the maze and the two another scholar publishing the JP 2012 and the French Swan also JP in the 2015. They use this utility function. This utility function looks well very complicated. And we find no cross-form solution for the directive utility function. And the substitution between the variety also is not constant anymore. That well depends on N and the beta. And now I move to another issue on the trend. A few minutes later before I mentioned, now the intermediate trade account about 2/3 of the trade in the world. So now intermediate trade is very, very important. So most of the result based on final trade now is not always the will be support. So the intermediate trade now is also new issue in the trade. I have a paper with the Japanese and the Ping Wang. Ping Wang also is a student from the others. So he supervised many very distinguished scholar in this field. So in this model, we developed two vertical integrated economies. And we allow the intermediate trade, but final trade is not allowed for trade. So we find that accumulation and the growth always positive in the final trade. But this argument, this claim, is not true when we consider the intermediate trade. And also in the final trade, we find the skill labor and skill labor, the gap. Under the correlation, the gap will be one. But when we consider the intermediate trade, this result is not robust. Then, I have working with the Ray Lisman and the Ping Wang in the working paper in August. We developed a dynamic model. But this paper, we developed a dynamic model for endogenous determined technology appeals for firm. So for firm, they can consider how many variety I want to use in domestic, how many variety I want to import. So the technology, the production technology will completely determined by the firm with respect to the profit and maximization. Then under the regulation, especially under the domestic trade regulation, we find that the domestic firm will reduce the range of the export. Also reduce the range of the domestic intermediate good production and reduce intermediate good producer markup because the trade cost is decreasing. For firm, we more prefer to use the intermediate good from the home. And then we find finally the final good output and the profit always increase. So will be benefit much for the domestic framework. Then in the FBI and the offshoring, as in the many papers, here I just give the two papers like Grossman, Hammond, I study and GDA. They study when the firm consider the outsourcing or FDI. Because they want to find some special component for him to produce very good. Then he will consider whether I want to outsource or FDI, like the matrix I mentioned in the first page. Then consider the outsourcing. They will require approach partner, which partner relationship will be specific investment, right? If by under the company control. And the helmet also provide another explanation for the trade structure for FDI, both within and between country. And the Navi and Otibano, the ET is a common series. They examine another model, is the consider the indigenous growth model with offshoring to investigate the impact on product innovation. So they consider another dimension in the product innovation. And so in that case, you will consider the trade cost, production cost, and then I also have a paper with the Ping Wang and the other scholar in Hong Kong, published in 2012 in IGL. We consider the three different organizations. The firm can buy the intermediate good or integration from upstream and downstream firm or outsourcing. So they will endorse and determine which kinds of pattern I want to choose. And they will determine the equipment, will determine the parameter of the trade cost, the production of the inflation rate, and another country. So this paper is the cover a few alternatives in the intermediate good trade framework. And this year I have another paper. We focus on the intelligent property law because under the globalization international trade, different countries have the different degree on the intelligent property law. So when I find a partner produce a component for me, I prefer what? If this country is the more stronger IPR, is the more protect my intellectual property law, then I will select better quality supply because his capability is higher, his productivity is higher, and this country IPR is much better. I always choose this. But if this country is the legal, is a weak legal institution, then maybe I will my choice will be different. I will choose more large range of the supplier. So then I have another paper to think about the other astronomy. Because in this paper, only consider the hobby right, but we consider another probability. The supplier, he produced the component for his partner, for the final good. Of course, the final good will be by the partner. It's higher probability, higher probability. But there will be another probability. But because the higher individual, the higher partner, its probability higher, that implies one. It has the potential to learn by doing to learn your technology, then transfer to produce another final good to compete with you. For example, like in the Japan, Mitsubishi Heavy Industry. You know this one? Mitsubishi Heavy Industry. They produce a component for Boeing airplane. 40% Boeing component is outsourcing to Mitsubishi Heavy Industry. Then, for Mitsubishi Heavy Industry, produce a component that is many, many knowledge, many, many know-how, many technology from the Boeing outsourcing. Then, from this year, the Mitsubishi Heavy Industry starting to produce the airplane for themselves, produce a medium-sized airplane. Then, this airplane will compete with his original partner, Boeing company. So this is this paper we discuss. So for the final good, I want to find a more capability, more productivity partner for me, because in that case, we know my production cost. But on the other side, he has much potential to produce the final good to compete with me in the next stage. So what's going on? We have the comprehensive exam and the different depends on some case where we will have the different group. Okay, now this is in progress, so now we can consider to complete this paper. The other is the game of trade is also is well half the issue in the international trade since the AER project 2012. They always took cut from the game of the trade. It's a loss of game. Oh, then we find Ken is well robust result. New trading model, the same old game. So what's the major difference? The managed model, global model, different model. But if we calculate the game of trade, the result is the same. Only depends on what? Depends on two parameters, sigma, epsilon, and the lambda. The epsilon is the trade elasticity through the trade cost. And the lambda is the domestic expected yield. So the lambda depends on this one. My course, Chin Mu Chen, presented the complete paper yesterday based on this model. For example, if the Otaki, the lambda is equal to 100, no import, no import, all the consumption goods is produced in domestic country. And if in the 2000, if the import is 7%, then lambda is equal to 93%. Then according to Anderson, we found the survey paper in 2004, the trade elasticity is between the negative 5 to 10. In the Pokemon model, they use from negative 3 to 7 to make all simulation. So under this case, we can calculate the gamma trade would be 1.4 or 0.7, which really depends on elasticity. So but this gamma trade model have two important concerns. The first one is the trade because is in balance, must be balanced. But now you know many balance trade or triangle trade is not balanced. The second is aggregate profit are constant share of the liquid. The third constraint is the import demand system must be CS. So under this consumption, like Eaton-Cotton model, Big model, Mayne's model, always will be whole. The gamble trade can use this formula to calculate the gamble trade. So, for example, the Big model, they use only intensive margin effect. So the epsilon, the elasticity depends on sigma minus one. But in the heterogeneous model of Mayne's model, they have two, one is intensive, the margin elasticity, the other is tensive. So the epsilon is depends on comma, the activity distribution, the shape. So, but even the parameter is different, but you still can use the epsilon to calculate the game of the trend. So now many scholars follow this one to reconsider to question this formula. The first is question the complete three restrictions. The three restrictions always hold or only hold two of them. So the other is find some empirical implication to estimate the trade efficiency. Then also somebody use this model to try to extend the other channel for the gamble trade. So from the preference side, they use BES utility function to reject the gamble trade for non-consecutive the preference for BES utility function. In the production side, they use the normal firm in the genus or truncate the polygonal firm distribution or use the two production sector because in the CS they always assume the production input only the layer. So I have the paper working on this way, follow the search. We examine the welfare game of choice. We combine the Lucas model, consider the labor. We have the two forces. One is the workforce, this is homogeneous, another is talent, is heterogeneous. Then the labor will be, it doesn't determine when he will become a worker or entrepreneur. Under equilibrium, the wage and the profit will be equal. In that case, we examine the gamble trade between the different agents because on the ACR model, only consider homogeneous agent, so only one input. So no difference. But here, we assume even the one label, they can separate to different agent. The other is from the estimate the trade model. I think the great model, everybody knows that, but in economics, we can see that the trade between the country I and country Z will be like this model, and the A is like the GDP of country I, and the B is like GDP or export or total output of the country Z. And now for the regional economies or trade line, will be more interesting is T. T is the trade cost between the I and Z. So the epsilon is the trade efficiency. So then we have some problem because we log both sides, then we will have this equation. But you know, not always have trade between country I and Z. Some trade between I and Z will be zero. Then not zero will be problem. So face this kind of economic problem, now they have two recommendations in the 2006 published ICE statistic to develop another model to overcome this problem. In the next page. But now I introduce the trade-off. The trade-off between I and Z is the general term. Depends on some observable variable. For example, the distance contingent is both country is a contingent or is a block or have the same name or is a common legal system or common language or they have colonial relationship before, like Taiwan and Japan have the colonial relationship before, or common currency like Eurozone or the common religion. So, in the people study, they always consider like this one. So, for example, in the 2040, they estimate this equation and find the beta. The beta is the distance per meter. Is is between the 0.22 to the 3.1. Depends on which year data. They use the 1970, 1980, 1990, 2000, and also pulling all the data together to estimate. But the beta, the parameter, always between the 0.2 to 0.3. So we can use this data. Then I said that this two parametrization overcome the zero trade problem. Then we write the trade model as this one. So this is distance. The z is the other variable for the of the trade. So then, because we have beta, then we can calculate the epsilon beta in this equation. And now we are considering the variable trade in the trade. So now I say it's not all the production in the same place. They always produce in a different country. I give an example like an iPod. Product. They produce, the component, we can consider that Japan contribute 96 bars, Korea 3, US 13, and other countries 13, then trade to the China to assemble. Then finally to transport to US retail price and Microsoft the US, Apple, not the Microsoft, Apple contributed another 80. So the total sale price is 299. But even the Japan in the hardware contributed 90 cents, but not always 90 cents produced in Japan. The 90 cents produced in Japan also produced in China, Japan, Philippines, and other countries in the hardware. Then to transport to Japan to assemble. This is just one example. The other example also the same thing. So now the variable chain is through the different countries. So the different countries. So now we mentioned the input-output model because the any component not only produced in the one country. So now we consider which country can use how much? Very interested for how much. So this is an input-output model for the international country. So we can decompose different country, different industry, and set up the input-output model. And we can measure the value editor for each component or each industry for specific country. Then we have multiple conditions, in terms of variable, in terms of quantity, also time constraint. I don't integrate for detail. If you are interested, you can see my my note. So like this one, so we can set up the input output matrix for the whole country. It's not for only one country. So like this one, this is intermediate produce. This is for final consumption. So the we have the global input output matrix, okay? And C is the full final consumption. Okay, then we can measure the variable data for each country for specific industry. And also we can sum of the variable for each country. So now I just introduced now it's many data sources we can use. Like this one is produced by Shin-Kun. It's covered 160 countries. And the industry, I think, is about 500. The year cover from 2002. So many the data. The data is Micro Foundation. It's a 4-digit firm level data. So it's very helpful for the trade guy to present the variable data issue for each country. Then so now it's many papers follow this table or follow this change then to working in different topic like in China or another is used BS or talking about the China, US imbalance. Many issue. I think I have given some well, recently press paper follow this way. Estimate very early for the different country. So and this part I still working in progress with my co-author. So I just give some example. This all the papers on is recently published in the last 2 or 3 years. Okay, since I just give only 7 minutes, so I don't interpret for detail for each papers, and so this paper is just published. This year, also is focused on China. This China data. The China data before is not reliable, but now the China data, many data is now is much helpful. They will seriously to set up the data for footage, but this some data set is very basic. If you want to use, you must be paid much money. So for the people guy, if you want to use the data, I think the data source, some data source now is free. You can free access, free trace, and use this data. But some data now is still must be paid. Okay, I just leave the 5 minutes to question and just overview the trend in population and the international trade topic. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Professor Shin-Kun Peng. In your lecture, we see that Professor Peng devotes so much effort on the new trade theory, and we appreciate that you give an overview of this new trade theory. Thank you very much. And any questions?
So I was wondering if we could go back to, thank you for your nice presentation, your very kind words. I was wondering if we could go back to some slides in the part on preferences.
Which page?
The one on preferences where you have VES, CES, Stone-Gehry.
The VES.
There.
This one?
This one, yeah. So recently I've been doing some work with Fujita Sensei.
Yes.
And one of the byproducts we found, we were using this sort of framework as an example. And one of the byproducts we found was that, yes, VES is the most general for, and yes, additively separable preferences and so on. When you get down to CES and you look at all the equilibria that can be generated by CES, yeah, it turns out that every equilibrium with VES preferences,
yes,
can be replicated by CES.
Okay.
So what that means is you come full cycle. That okay, every equilibrium is actually CES equilibrium.
Okay, thank you very much for Professor Brady's comments. Then we will be much interested because now why VES will be used? Because some the shortcut of the CES cannot interpret. So now many scholars start to consider the VES. But if the VES, like Marcus said, Professor Brady said, can in the equilibrium or some result can be duplicated to by CS, then I think the VS contribution will be not so general. So that's more interesting. So maybe we Professor Brady, you can bring another BS.
I just don't want to make Jack angry.
Okay.
Thank you. Any questions? Okay, please.
Thank you very much for the lecture. I want to ask about the measurement of the welfare gain from trade. It seems that many of the previous studies based on market structure, which is monopolistic competition or perfect competition, like the merits or yes. But in some industries, the market structure is oligopolistic. So I want to ask you about so can we whether we can apply the same procedure to the case of oligopolistic market?
Okay. Thank you for the Dr. Yanasi's comment. I think the game of trade calculate is not only a perfect competition. They can use in like the performance, the monopolist competition, or like the maze model, also is the monopolist competition. But in the EK model, even total model is a perfect competition. Of course, all these models based on the CES function. If we want to convert to another framework, like you mentioned, is the oligopoly, the model, I think, not only change for the oligopoly, the production frame, we also need to change the UT function. Because now, if oligopoly, for example, in only three firms, three industries, then the UT function only consume the three products. Then we can, I think we can consider, we examine this game of trade. If still match the three different constraints, our oligopoly, this formula still can use. But if I bet from these three contract, then this formula must be revised. Thank you. I just replied for this. Thank you.
Any questions? We see her one more time. No. May I ask an unprofessional question about that? As we know that Professor Donald Trump is very conservative in international trade,
yes,
and do you think that this policy will be a disaster or nightmare to the international trade in the future?
I think I can answer this so comprehensive model. Because I think for politician, when he consider the choice, not only for the game of the trade or something. They also consider here, we haven't considered the program. Like now many politicians is more concerned under the regulation is employment. Employment is a real hard issue. because if the unemployment rate is increasing, then let's start voting, he will lose many, many voting. So I think if A consider the other issue of employment, that I think will be more complicated. This the formula must be the multiple. Here is very simple, very simple. Only use the one input under the CS utility function. If change this one, then many will be changed. Okay, thank you, Professor Lai.
Thank you, Professor Shin-Kun Peng. Now it's 12:30, so let's give a big appreciation for Shin-Kun Peng's lecture. Thank you very much.
Thank you.